shift change in 30 minutes. All day personnel are required to take full advantage of sleep periods.
Coffee break?
Oh, yeah. Put it on the table. Thanks.
Get out, gentlemen.
This is Flight Director Banner. Are you reading an oxygen bleed with Scorpio 1?
Scorpio 1, oxygen mix, now pure oxygen.
Oh my God.
Sir, the chance of fire is...
100%! Get me the president.
Yes, Mr. President. Mr. President, we will find the best man for the job. Thank you, sir.
Director Parlo, Ms. Gibson is here with the files.
Send her in.
Sir.
Who's available?
Stevens is in Taiwan. Owensby is in a military hospital in Frankfurt.
Christ, 3 months till retirement, and this falls into my lap. Who else have we got?
Stone, sir. He's in Iraq, but I think he's just tying up some loose ends.
Get him.
Ah,
We got company.
Respect, Director Parlow. I am supposed to command a shuttle mission to Scorpio 1. If there's a chance that anyone is still alive on that space station, I need a rescue team that has space flight experience. I just don't see how your man Stone fits into that picture.
And with all due respect to you, Commander Wilson, there are concerns about events on Scorpio 1 that extend beyond the scope of NASA's interests. And that is where Mr. Stone and his team come in.
Team?
Yes. Accompanying Mr. Stone will be a team of 5 Army Rangers, experienced in medevac. And I believe the signature at the bottom will, well, remove your concerns about Mr. Stone's bona fides.
Would you mind telling me what interest the CIA has in Scorpio 1?
Sorry, Commander, but I believe you would agree that there's no need for you to know that at this point.
So, in effect, I'm just a space taxi service, a mother dropping off her kids at baseball practice.
No.
Look, Commander, we don't really know what we're going to find up there, and we will need to rely on one another. This is my mission, but I will defer to your judgment whenever I feel it's appropriate.
Fair enough.
All right. Well, now, gentlemen, if you will excuse me, I must go dress for one of the many retirement dinners that I must attend.
Commander, Ranger team is good to go.
Is this gonna hurt much, Miss Bray?
Shannon, Mr. Stone. We're informal here. And it only hurts the first time, right, Carter?
Like a roller coaster. You zoom up, then you puke. Thanks. Little less chatter, people. You got a mission to fly. This Commander Wilson you got here is a nice guy.
Oh, don't worry about him. He's been a little touchy ever since Nixon canceled his Apollo mission back in 72. Apollo 20, I think it was.
Launch control, this is Houston.
We are go for launch.
Roger, Houston, Atlantis KSC. T-minus 20 seconds and counting. T-minus 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5.
We'll take it from here.
Beginning roll program.
Roger, Atlantis, this is Houston. Your go for throttle up.
Atlantis, you are go for SRB separation.
Solid rocket booster, hang on. Say 10 hours.
Let's just hope somebody's home when we get there.
Aye, aye to that, sir.
Today's launch is another example of how this government is wasting taxpayers' money. We're spending millions of dollars to launch a shuttle to save a $1 trillion space station we never should have built in the first place. Now, folks, that dog don't hunt.
Senator Treadwell!
Yes, ma'am.
As chairman of the NASA Oversight Committee, isn't it your job to find ways to help our space program?
I plan to help the space program. Needs to go on a diet.
Killer sound. Who do we have on Senator Treadwell?
Agent Green's meeting with the informant tonight.
The gregarious Mr. Cottle. Does the senator suspect anything?
Well, according to Green, Cottle's been a trusted aide for a decade. Cottle told Green that Treadwell may be involved with an arms manufacturer, March Ocean Laboratories.
I know them. They supply weapons to terrorists. Apparently, the senator's diversifying his interests. You know, when I first began working with the agency back in 56, Alan Dulles told me something I'll never forget. He said 90% of the world's wars could be avoided with one well-trained assassin and one well-aimed bullet. I miss the old days.
Jesus.
Green? Green? Is that you? Green?
Senator, it feels you've been talking to strangers too much, Cottle.
It's very dangerous.
No, I didn't say anything.
Well, the Senator no longer requires your services.
Senator thanks you for your support. Let him go.
Oh my God. What could have happened to them?
Scorpio 1, this is Atlantis. Scorpio 1.
Any radio contact?
Negative, sir.
Stand by for docking.
Capcom, Atlantis. Docking procedure to commence in T-minus 1 minute and counting.
Hey, isn't that one of those old Apollo capsules?
Used as an emergency escape vehicle. Reliable old workhorse.
Aren't there supposed to be two?
Yeah, there were. Watch your speed.
Got it.
Easy.
Atlantis, docking is complete. We'll prep our boarding party. Next contact in 60 minutes.
Captain Till, you and your men can remove your helmets.
Thanks for the ride.
That's an E-ticket.
Captain, what next?
Wait for orders, Corporal Baker.
Same old army.
All right, listen up, people. From this point on, the mission is under command of Mr. Stone. You are authorized to assist Mr. Stone and the Rangers in any way that they see fit, short of ignoring your shipboard duties, or endangering the shuttle, or the crew. What are your orders, Mr. Stone?
Pretty simple, Commander. We suit up, go inside, and see what we can find.
Hutton, I want pressure suits and oxygen ready for possible survivors. Have them standing by in the airlock.
Right away, Commander.
Carter? Weighted boots.
Aye, aye, sir.
And make sure that Mr. Stone's zipper doesn't get stuck.
Roger that, sir.
Scorpio 1 is open to space.
Your birdie, Mr. Stone.
Carter, you take the Rangers. I want you to cover the control room and the power cell bay.
What about the lab?
That's mine. You and Wilson go check the crew quarters and the rest of the tubes.
Oh, sure not.
Yeah, these are M4 laser rifles. Fire on the same principle as a finely directed flashlight beam, but these lights kill. Careful, it's not a squirrel gun.
I never liked guns.
Well, Mr. Hutton, guns don't kill people. We do.
Check his helmet seal.
Maybe. He
Captain, have your men move the bodies to the empty docking tube.
Hutton, get up here. We have a problem with the onboard computer.
What is it?
I'm showing a critical power loss in our main cells.
I just checked them.
Atlantis, Houston, we're showing a power loss.
Roger, Houston. I think it's a software malfunction. I'm going to trigger a power surge. Stand by.
Jesus.
Get me backup power. Now! Houston. Atlantis? Houston.
Atlantis, the problem is on your end.
Yeah, no shit.
Commander, we've lost our main power cells.
Check with Houston. It could be a computer error.
Commander, we've lost power.
I'm on backup.
Well, that's damn convenient.
I appreciate you coming on such short notice, Director. I have to brief the President in half an hour on this Scorpio 1 mission.
I'm afraid we're in the dark, sir. Atlantis has reported a power drain at 2124 hours. Houston confirmed, and one of our Rangers is dead.
Is this a sabotage situation?
We're trying to find out. Stone thinks it looks like an accident.
Tell me, Wilford, are your spy boys ever going to figure out what the hell's going on before another American dies on this thing?
They're using every available resource, sir.
Well, your resources ain't giving me squat, Director.
Senator, the car's here.
Right, Johnson.
There's another matter that I need to discuss with you, sir, before you leave. Your aide, Cottle. As you know, last night he was found dead.
Heart attack. Damn shocking. Cottle was a good man. Just couldn't handle the pressure. Washington's a tough town, and like I told old dear Cottle, if you can't handle the heat, get the hell out the kitchen.
It seems he didn't take your advice.
At present, we only have enough backup to power life support and the ship's routine functions. And we lose that in about 24 hours.
We're dead.
Maybe not. What if we flood Scorpio 1 with Atlantis's extra oxygen and then move everyone over there? We tie into their power cells and recharge our own. Just like jumping a car battery.
It's never been done.
So?
So? What if we blow it? You don't even know if the circuits are compatible.
Power's power. If I can calculate the amps correctly and don't blow too many fuses, I just have to be careful not to use too much power doing the work. But Hutton and I can do it in, what, 12 hours?
Absolutely.
You have to shut off the heat in there. Freeze your tails off.
I brought my mittens.
Were there any needle marks?
They didn't need it. Autopsy reported traces of a horse liniment called DMSO. Bodybuilders used to use it. When you mix it with cyanide, it's lethal. Absorbed through the skin, directly into the bloodstream, kills in minutes.
Symptoms of a heart attack. The senator's getting a little too clever for his own good. Did he need to kill Cottle?
Maybe he's panicking.
Gentlemen. Bank statements. The American Liberty Foundation. A private PAC that contributed a great deal of money to Treadwell's campaign war chest. And the American Liberty Foundation gets its funding from a Cayman Island account held by March Ocean Laboratories.
Our friends in the press would call this a smoking gun. Mr. Green, I believe the March Ocean Laboratories have corporate offices in Los Angeles. Now, why don't you take a plane out there and break in? Nothing elaborate, you understand. Just play around a little bit on their computer.
Excuse me, sir. I would like to go. I'm sure that I can break into their mainframe.
This is Black Ops, my dear. An illegal break-in. Are you sure?
Oh, come on, sir. Haven't had this much fun since Watergate.
Thank you.
Oxygen's at normal.
Check.
Heat level's normal, sir.
Excellent.
Scorpio's breathing again.
Yeah.
Carter in master control. It's like the Bahamas in here, and the air's great.
Good. You coming?
Yeah, just a second. Know anybody with wire cutters? Big ones?
Excuse me, sir. Scorpio's got atmosphere again.
Yes. Yeah.
That'll buy him some time.
Coffee and cold rations await your presence.
Oh, God. Thank you.
Excuse me. Carter told me this crap is leftover K rations from Nam. You are Nam, Roger, is that true?
Yeah. That was in Black Ops. We ate ration mud. Me and John Wayne, Pilgrim.
Progress. Circuit boards are fried, but I think I can jury-rig it so it'll handle a power transfer from Scorpio. But Commander, why would anybody cut our power lines? Fade lines. Now it had to happen after we reached orbit. A cut like that during the launch would have blown us up on the pad. Oh, I can fix it easily enough. I just can't figure out why they'd do it. I mean, somebody wants us to stay up here a little longer?
We're up here as long as Stone wants us to be.
Well, maybe our saboteur doesn't know that.
Stone, maybe he has some answers.
Oh, my God. Are you all right? Oh,
Maury.
What the hell happened to you?
It's a long story. I'll tell you about it later.
Gotta kill me.
All right, go ahead, open it.
Also pick safes.
Oh. Gotcha. Phew. Uh-huh. Well, look at this. Looks like Senator Treadwell and the boys at March Ocean are supplying NASA with astronauts.
See if anybody else is on there.
Not now. Let's just copy it.
Hey, isn't that one of the astronauts from Atlantis?
Okay, all right, that's it. We got it.
Disc back to Washington.
Oh,
go.
So long, friend.
Cross your fingers. I think we're good to go.
Copy.
Scorpio, we are ready for main cell recharge.
Roger, Atlantis, stand by.
It'll be a hell of a blowing fuse if your calculations are wrong.
Well, if I know Shannon, there isn't a chance of that happening.
Status?
Hot damn, money in the bank.
Scorpio, Atlantis mains at full charge.
Good work, Hutton.
Hey, listen up, people. Good news. Atlantis is powered up and we are going home.
All right. Let's get ready. Let's start moving our gear back to the shuttle.
I'm gonna go get some coffee. Need anything?
Yeah. Give me a latte with whipped cream.
One space station coming up.
And it sprinkles stuff on top, too.
So that's what we came here for?
This is what Scorpio One died for. Whoever controls cold fusion is going to run the show for a while. Incredible. A handful of this stuff could power up LA for over 100 years. What's a few innocent lives when you can control the future, huh?
You really think somebody killed all those people just for a lousy computer disk?
They killed a ranger yesterday. They tried to kill me in the escape tube. Somebody wants this disk in a big, big way.
We've got a saboteur aboard my space shuttle, Stone. What are you gonna do about that?
I'm gonna find out who it is. And I'm gonna kill him.
Coming out of there? I want some coffee.
I'm gonna double check a few things first. Stick around.
I may need you.
Aye, aye. You anal retentive bitch.
My pilot tells me somebody actually cut our power feed lines. Somebody on board Atlantis.
I figure I've got the disk.
Then why don't they just take it?
They'll try. Right now, they're just buying time.
Got you now.
Smell that shit!
Sir?
What is it, Corporal?
Is there anything else we need to move aboard Atlantis?
This computer, come here, I want you to take a look at this. Look right at this.
Smoked out the bad guys. My crew as cannon fodder. You are one cold-hearted bastard, mister.
If I wasn't, by now we'd all be dead.
The invasion begins, huh?
You got it, soldier. Yeah. Get him into the airlock.
Thank you.
Plan B, gentlemen. Stone still has the disc. We've got to persuade him to give it to us.
Davis, you go back to the shuttle. Rogers and I, we're going to grab the weapons and follow. All right? Hutton.
Hutton, come in.
Go ahead.
Davis is moving.
Prison ship Atlantis, darling.
You son of a bitch. You sabotaged our power lines.
Highly paid son of a bitch.
Airlock sealed.
Hutton, kill the oxygen feed to Scorpio.
We've got us a little hostage situation here.
We have your pilot in control of Atlantis.
You're on Vox, Captain.
Mr. Stone has something that we want.
Steel.
As you know, we've already cut off the oxygen supply to Scorpio.
You've got about an hour left. Mr. Stone has a computer disk.
If I get it, I'll put your pilot back on board Scorpio.
With an adequate oxygen supply for you and your crew. We'll fly home. You wait for the next shuttle.
If I don't, she dies. Within the hour. The rest of you.
If you kill her, how are you gonna fly that shuttle, buddy?
Oh, I think Mr. Hutton will hold our hands.
Hutton?
Sorry to interrupt your retirement dinner, sir.
It's all right. It's all right, my dear. Food was lousy anyway.
They were waiting for us. Somebody tipped him off.
Senator Treadwell.
Well, everything appears to be on the disc. Enough to take down Treadwell and March Ocean Laboratories. But not enough to save Atlantis. Any word?
No. I'm afraid Stone is their only hope. If he's still alive.
You find Whitley?
In the rear airlock. What's left of him? Rigged to look like an accident.
They're not leaving any witnesses, are they?
They can't. Look, they already killed two Army Rangers. They took out the entire crew of Scorpio 1. All they have to do is wait for us to die. Then they come in and get the disc. They just want us to make it easy for them.
Well, we're not gonna do that. Carter?
Sir?
Get me the telemetry data on our orbit.
Aye, aye.
I want to know what a 5-second ohm burst will do to our position.
Yes, sir.
I'm curious. Why?
Money. Pure and simple. I've been killing for my country for a lot of years. You know what? I got to be pretty good at it. Thought it was time I should start doing it for myself. Man my age needs to start thinking about retirement. I made friends with a very influential senator.
Friends in high places.
He made me an offer I couldn't refuse. What about you, Hutton?
Got a lot of unresolved childhood anger. This is my chance to strike a blow for my inner child.
Is that what you became an astronaut for?
Shut up.
Sir, a 5-second burn will knock us out of safe orbit. Orbit deteriorates in 2 hours.
I'm not gonna like this, am I?
It means we'll burn up.
Stand by to engage on my command.
Yes, sir.
Time's a-wasting, boys.
You got a deal, Till.
Now you are one smart spaceman.
I want Stone to put the disc in the docking tube. When I see it, you'll get your lovely pilot back.
Affirmative.
Is she listening?
She's right here. I haven't touched her.
Yet.
Hang in there, Shannon.
You'll get that Bermuda sunburn yet.
Is that some kind of joke, Wilson?
Now, Carter.
What was that?
Scorpio's locked us to the tube.
Unlock it.
I can't. It's remoted from their control panel.
Hang on.
What was that?
A bitch threw us out of orbit.
Fix it.
I can't. Not while we're attached to Scorpio. Not enough time to calculate a correct burn.
How long, Carter?
5.04, sir.
Good girl.
The Bermuda sunburn.
NASA flight school. Emergency course correction procedure. We still locked on, Carter?
Like a pit bull, Commander.
They control the failsafe from their bridge. Prevents disengagement if Atlantis's docking arm fails.
We're gonna go get them.
That's what they want.
That's what I want! Move out.
Son of a bitch.
Oxygen levels at 50%.
We have 2 hours before we run out of oxygen and burn up in the Earth's atmosphere. Your call, Mr. Stone.
Carter, let's go set up a surprise for our friends.
I like this guy.
Federal agents, put your hands up!
Down, put it
down! Hold!
Look out!
Come on, Joel.
Right there.
I'm begging you.
FBI,
get him out of here.
Come on,
let's go.
Get him out of here. Come on, let's go. Go.
Hey. Well done, my dear. Mm-hmm. Send in a cleaning team. I'm going inside.
Stay there.
Ha 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 ha. No, no. No, Senator. No. No. It's all right. It's all right, Senator. Listen to me. It was an elaborate plan, and not without style. Arbitrarily killing a handful of scientists and destroying a space station, just so you could steal cold fusion. You know, when I figured out what you were doing, I decided to let you run with it. I wanted to see if you could carry it off. I even tried to help you. I slowed our internal investigation, set up one of our informants, one of our agents. My God, you were so very, very sloppy. DMSO, mixed with cyanide. It's the same thing you used on your unfortunate aide. And as you recall, Senator, the poison is absorbed through the skin and then pumped very quickly to the heart. Pump, pump, pump. I think you could call this dramatic irony. No, 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 no. Senator. I'm getting very close to retirement. And it has occurred to me that this little scheme of yours could use some new blood. Someone smart enough to take it to the finish. I'm taking it over. See you in hell, Senator.
Personnel mine. Barbecue a bad guy with no messy fire on board.
No muss, no fuss, huh?
They're coming.
Commander, it's Carter. They're coming.
Roger that, Carter. Place that in the rear corridor. Don't wait for me. Go.
gonna be all right, Carter.
You got any good drugs, Commander?
Damn hippie.
I really did it this time, didn't I, Commander?
Well, I'm afraid so.
Oh, boy.
Okay, here.
All right,
come on.
All right.
Just hold it there.
Okay.
Give me your arm.
That's gonna hurt.
Oh, it's not gonna hurt at all. The feel-good stuff.
Oh, yeah. I'm getting all warm and fuzzy.
Two of the bad guys. They killed Ridley.
And me, more or less.
Well, Till and Hutton are on board. Where's Stone?
Waiting for Till. Okay, tough guy.
Thank you.
buy one of those things?
First time for everything.
Ripped away part of the heat shield.
He'll burn up on re-entry. He's got a one-way ticket to hell. He just doesn't know it yet.
Yes!
Shannon, give me status.
Atlantis bled some oxygen to us during the firefight. Reserves at 25%. Re-entry begins at 0940, and this ship isn't built for re-entry.
So that means no matter what, we're gonna burn up in about 30 minutes.
Maybe not. What about the other Apollo capsule?
We don't even know if it's operational.
We don't have a choice. You think you can power up that antique, Carter?
If you can fly it, sir.
Seems to me I almost did once.
See, but that's the part that kind of bothers us.
Oh, shit.
What?
I forgot we got a couple of bombs on board.
Where?
In the power cell bay.
We've got work to do, bud.
Capsule.
Catch, Carter.
Should have known better, huh?
Yes, you should.
Easy. Got one.
Yeah, me too. Right there. Got it? Hold still.
Damn.
These bombs cannot be defused. Can we lose this through the airlock?
Oh, not without going with them. We don't have any pressure suits.
Can you still get in this thing?
Watch me.
Start your power up procedure.
Power up procedures underway.
Pacific tracking reports Atlanta's position for re-entry.
Roger. Equals on preset. Auto re-entry code. Set.
Can you raise them?
No, sir. Atlantis entering blackout phase.
Right. Check your telemetry, sir.
Roger. Telemetry is full function. Just a kid. How'd you ever learn about this old tin can?
I was a space nerd in junior high. You guys are my heroes. Don't forget to tie your
Life support to back up batteries, sir.
Oh, yeah, got it. Okay, thank you, Carter.
They should be out of blackout by now.
Capcom?
I think we're there.
Let's rock and roll.
All right. The bad news is the bombs cannot be disarmed. About 4 minutes, we're gonna be toast.
Can she make it?
No pressure suits, heat shields 20 years old, parachute's probably full of mothballs, but she will fly.
All right, we're going.
Better hurry up.
All right, Carter, come on, let's go.
No. There's only oxygen for three. My weight will throw off the telemetry. I'm dead anyway. You guys haven't got a snowball's chance in hell, Sylvie.
I don't really give a shit what you think. You're going. Come on.
Don't.
Come on.
Don't. He's right.
Thanks, darling. It's your ass in there. Don, did you get what you came for?
Yeah, got it. Good luck on the other side, buddy.
Watch the first step. It's a big one.
Well done, Carter.
Aye, aye, sir.
Stand by to fire explosive bolts. Seconds from my mark.
Standing by.
Mark. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fire. In 3, 2, 1. How long?
15 seconds. Any time now, give or take a few seconds. Now what?
Re-entry. If the heat shield holds up. Otherwise, it's been memorable.
Not gonna believe this, but it looks-
Looks like we're gonna have ourselves a good old-fashioned Apollo splashdown.
Capcom, could you repeat that, please?
We've got an Apollo capsule. Reshoots open. Navy copter's on the way for resave. Command module looks good.
Apollo.
Rotation caller.
Splashdown successful. She's still holding up after all these years.
The ship is secure, Commander.
Apollo 20 has landed. Give me some of that air.
Oh, God. Holy Mother of God.
Here he comes.
That's a great old car.
Yeah.
They don't make them like that anymore, do they?
Well, I pray they don't make anything like they used to anymore. Even war. You have the disc.
You should know that's not secured information anymore.
What do you mean?
About an hour ago, I put that on the internet. You see, I think no single government should have that much power.
And how long have you known?
Miss Gibson called me this afternoon after she spoke to the Pentagon.
I've had my suspicions ever since the senator's aide died. How did Treadwell know we were onto him? The mess in L.A. confirmed it. The March Ocean people knew we were coming, and you were the only one who could have told them.
You know, when they built this car, it was supposed to last forever.
Nothing lasts forever, Wilfred.
I don't think that I could last for a trial. Appeals, they take so many years.
That way there'd be no pension for the family, you know.
Leaving it in my hands.